Mother's Day Sunday. You guys, did you get to do something that you like to do last week? Because last Sunday was Children's Day, right? And today, you have to do something for mom today. What do you want to do? You want to wash dishes? You want to throw your trash away? Do you want to clean your room? Think of something that you can do for your mom and make sure you do it before today, okay? Let's put our hands together and open up with the prayer. Let's pray. Repeat after me.
하나님, 감사합니다. 하나님께서 사랑이 많은 엄마를 주셔서 매일매일 사랑을 받고 자랄 수 있도록 도와주셔서 감사합니다. 큰 사랑을 받은 우리가 친구들과 가족들과 다른 사람들에게 이 사랑을 넘치도록 전할 수 있도록 도와주세요. 예수님 이름으로 기도합니다. 아멘.
My mom is helpful.
Helpful.
Kind.
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 My mom is strong.
Strong.
Strong mom.
Super mom.
따뜻해.
따뜻해요.
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 똑똑해요.
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 예뻐요.
예뻐요.
Okay, it's time for praise. So on the count of three, you have to stand up and say Holy Spirit really loud, okay? Let's go. One, two, three. Stand up. Holy Spirit.
얘들아, 지금은 헌금 시간이에요. 우리 모두 찬양 드리면서 준비한 헌금을 두 손 모아 하나님께 드려요.
하나님, 근데 코로나 바이러스 빨리 없어지게 해주세요. 그리고 또 우리 교회, 가게 해주세요. 예수님 이름으로 기도합니다. 아멘.
Okay, guys. So I have only 5 kids that told me that got 100% on the quiz. And some people got 4 right, 3 right. And it's okay. If you get it wrong, you have to try again. Try again and again and until you get 100%, and make sure you tell your mom so that I get to know. And by the end of this month, I'll give you a little prize, okay? So listen to the sermon very carefully. Open your eyes, open your ears, and pay close attention, okay? Good morning, boys and girls. We're going to learn about Jesus' early miracles today. What are miracles? Miracles are amazing things that people cannot normally do. These miracles pointed ahead to Jesus' greater miracle. Through Jesus, God does for us what we cannot do for ourselves. He provides forgiveness and life with God forever. Over the next few weeks, we will learn about some amazing things Jesus did on earth. And there are 4 Bible books about Jesus' life on earth called the Gospels. Gospels are actually the first 4 books of the New Testament. These are Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And today we're going to look into Mark chapter 2, and it's the 2nd book of the New Testament. In our Bible story today, we will learn how Jesus helped people with all kinds of problems. Jesus cares about people, so Jesus' miracles helped people. Jesus and his disciples traveled to a town called Capernaum. Jesus went into a synagogue, it's like a church today, and started teaching. The people there were very surprised. Jesus was not like other teachers. He spoke with power like someone in charge. Suddenly, a man with an unclean spirit shouted, "Why are you here, Jesus? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus commanded the spirit to be quiet and come out of the man. The spirit came out. Everyone was amazed. "Who is this Jesus?" they asked. "He teaches with power and the unclean spirits obey him." People all across the land were talking about Jesus. Next, Jesus and his disciples went to Simon and Andrew's house. Remember the 2 fishermen that became Jesus' first disciples? Simon, the Peter, his mother-in-law was in bed with a fever. Jesus went to her, took her hand, and healed her. She immediately got up and began to serve them. That evening, a large crowd of people came to the house with others who were sick or bothered by evil spirits, and Jesus healed them too. Early the next morning, Jesus went out by himself to pray. Simon and the other disciples found him and said, "Everyone is looking for you." Jesus said, "Let's go on to the nearby villages so I can preach there too. This is why I have come." Jesus traveled throughout the land. He preached and drove out demons. One day, a man with a skin disease came to Jesus. He got on his knees and begged him, "If you are willing, you can make me clean." Jesus was willing, and he healed the man. Boys and girls, did you listen carefully to the message? Let's talk about the three things that Jesus did as he started his ministry. So if you look at this, we know the first thing that he did was he was teaching. So he taught about the words of the Lord, the Bible, to people, and he preached. Let's look at this carefully. He preached and he talked about the kingdom of God, which is heaven, and how our sinners like us can go to heaven, right? And today's message actually focused on the last part of Jesus's ministry. He healed people. He was like a doctor. But you know what? Today's title is about Jesus's early miracles. So we learned that miracles are something that we cannot normally do. So even as a pastor, I can't do it. Even as students, you can't do it. Any, even adults who are the smart, who are rich, who have a lot of good things, cannot even do it. Only Jesus can do the miracles because he is the Son of God, right? So let's review the three people that he healed today. The first person was a man with an evil spirit. So we know by words, he drove out the evil spirit in him, right? And the second person that he met was Simon Peter's mother-in-law. And she had high fever. And when Jesus reached out his hand, she got better immediately. So he's a really great doctor, right? And the last person that he met was a man who had a skin disease. And he kneeled down, he begged Jesus and said, "If you are willing, Jesus, you can make me better." And when he said that, Jesus definitely said, "I am willing and I want you to get better." And when he said that, the man with the skin disease, he got better. So we learned that those three people's names are not even written in the Bible. So we don't know what their names are, but we know that Jesus cared about them and he loved them. And the reason why he performed the miracles was not to brag about himself, not to show off that he can do it, but to help people. And he has the same heart that goes for us today, because you guys may be sick. You guys may have hard time emotionally because you haven't gone anywhere, right? You are staying home and you are not going to school. You didn't come to church today and you're spending most of your time with your family at home, and you may be very struggling with something, and Jesus listens to you and he has heart for you and he has compassionate heart for you that he wants us to get better. So even though we don't have the evil spirit inside of us, even though we don't have the skin disease, even though we don't have high fever, sometimes when we struggle, Jesus loves to reach out his hand and help us. So you guys always have to remember to pray, because he does listen to our prayer and he's going to help us feel better and get better whenever we need Jesus's help. So why don't we put our hands together and let's pray to Jesus, okay? Jesus, thank you so much for showing the miracles for those people who needed your help. And we know that you have shown this miracle to help people, and you have the same compassionate heart for me and all of the kindergarten students as well. And please help us to continue to pray so that we know that you listen, so that we know that you will heal us, because you are the perfect doctor. Thank you so much for today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Kindergarten friends, welcome to our Bible quiz time. Listen to the questions very carefully, and if you know the answer, say them out loud. 우리 친구들 준비됐나요? Let's begin. 1. What did Jesus do for the people who were sick? The answer is, he healed them. Yes, Jesus healed the blind, the crippled, and many more who were sick. 2. When did Jesus go out by himself to pray? The answer is, early in the morning. Just like Jesus, do you guys pray in the morning? I know the parents are praying from 9 a.m. and 9 p.m. every day, so I hope you also pray like Jesus. Question number 3. Where did Jesus want to go so he could preach more? Preach means sharing the gospel. Answer is nearby villages throughout the land. That's why today we have missionaries who go out to different countries sharing the gospel. For you, you can share the gospel with your neighbors and your friends. So far, so good, right, guys? Question number 4. Does Jesus care about people? Of course, the answer is yes. He cares about you. He cares about your parents. He cares about your friends and our church. That's why we have service online. Hallelujah. Did you get them all right so far? Here's our last question, the most important question of the day. What makes people special? People are special because God made us in His own image. That means we're created just like Jesus. That's why you feel happy, sad, lonely, and scared. But that's okay. We have Jesus who gives us joy and peace during this time. Have a great day!
So this month's memory verse is John 3:16, and all of you should know it. Let's say it all together. Ready, go. For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have eternal life. John 3:16, amen. Very good. And I told you today I brought in Korean. So we're going to say it slowly all together. And some of you guys are struggling with Korean. So I brought a song. So you're going to listen to the song after we say it 2 times. And whenever you guys have time, listen to it every single day. And it'll be easier for you to memorize. Okay? Let's say it in Korean 1 time. And then we're going to repeat 1 more time. Ready? Go. 하나님이 세상을 이처럼 사랑하사 독생자를 주셨으니 이는 그를 믿는 자마다 멸망치 않고 영생을 얻게 하려 하심이니라. 요한복음 3장 16절 말씀. 아멘. Let's say a little bit faster this time. Ready and go. 하나님이 세상을 이처럼 사랑하사 독생자를 주셨으니 이는 그를 믿는 자마다 멸망치 않고 영생을 얻게 하려 하심이니라. 요한복음 3장 16절 말씀. 아멘. Okay, it's time for us to listen to the song. Listen carefully and listen to it every single day, okay?
요한복음 3장 16절 말씀.
세상을 이처럼 사랑하사 독생자를 주셨으니 이는 저를 믿는 자마다 멸망치 않고 영생을 얻게 하려 하심이니라. 요한복음 3장 16절 말씀. 사랑하사 독생자를 주셨으니 이는 저를 믿는 자마다 멸망치 않고 영생을 얻게 하려 하심이니라. 요한복음 3장 16절 말씀.
Today's activity is matching cards.
So today we talked about three miracles that Jesus performed, but in the Bible we have countless miracles that Jesus performed because he cared about people, right? So those things you haven't learned yet, but we're going to try to match the card and talk about the miracles that Jesus had performed, okay? In later on, we're going to learn some of these events as well, okay? So if you look at this first picture, we have a man who's lying down and Jesus healed the servant. This is the right answer. This is the matching card. And the second picture, Jesus heals the bleeding woman. This woman was bleeding for many, many years, but Jesus healed her. And the next picture, the Lazarus, Jesus's, one of Jesus's best friend, when he died, he raises Lazarus from dead. And Jesus, you probably have heard of this story before. Jesus walked on water, and you see the 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish, and with those, Jesus fed 5,000 men only. So if you have counted the woman and the children, then it would be a lot more than 5,000, right? And going to the next column, Jesus heals the blind man. And the next one is Jesus heals the sick girl. And this one, you probably have heard of the story as well. Jesus calms the storm. And Jesus also heals the leper. And Jesus heals the paralyzed man. And these are only 10 of the miracles that Jesus performed in the Bible. And it will be nice if you guys know all of them. So try to play this matching card game with your brother or sister or even with your parents, okay? Bye-bye.
Okay, we're going to end today's worship with the Lord's Prayer. Make sure you sing out loud and you mean it, okay? Let's sing it. So today's prayer, actually this week's prayer, is for the family. I know for past 4 weeks we've been praying for different topics on coronavirus to go away. Today's topic is pray for families adjusting to new ways of life. So you will see the slide and you will also have a paper with you. Let's read this all together. Ready? Go. Please be with families as we stay home together. Give everyone grace for each other, and may we speak words of kindness and encouragement. Also, help us to find creative ways to have fun as a family. In Jesus's name, I pray, amen. So this is the prayer especially for our family, so make sure you pray every single day. And if you have clips of you praying, please send it to me, okay? And today is a special day, like I've told you to, in the beginning of the worship. Today is Mother's Day. So you have to do a lot of things for mom. So there's no Zoom meeting today. And also, if your mom and mom doesn't know, there's going to be a gift from church. So if your mom has time, come as a family, come to church between 1 to 3 p.m. and the church is going to give a Mother's Day gift. So it's a drive-through. So come by church, get the gift, and you get to go home. So make sure to tell your mom to come to church between 1 to 3 p.m. Okay? Have a great Sunday, and I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
Happy Mother's Day. 모든 유치부 엄마들 사랑.